So back in 2014, Abbott Laboratories got into the CGM business with the launch of the Freestyle Libre, which was a small puck-shaped device that delivered on-demand, non-invasive glucose readings. And I did a review on it, and I was super impressed with how comfortable it was and how well it performed. Now, with about 6 years and a few additional products under their belt, they've finally done it. They've created the world's smallest, thinnest, most indiscreet CGM. Let's talk about it.
I've got insulin, it works, come home quick. We ran out of insulin too. Some of our patients who had been treated and were well died from lack of insulin. That was a hectic time, particularly for me. And of course we did rediscover how to do it, and the secret can never be lost.
Hey everyone, welcome back to the Type Me Diabetes and Lifestyle channel. It's been a crazy, crazy year, and I just wanted to thank you guys for continuing to enjoy, share, and subscribe to our content. If you love tech like me, you're always looking for ways to utilize and manage your overall health using technology, and today we're gonna do that by talking about the new Libre 3. But before we jump into that, I just wanted to let you guys know that this is not a sponsored video. If you're looking to have your product sponsored, however, feel free to send me an email or hit me up on the socials, and I will do my review and give you my honest opinion on your product. So what I'm gonna do today is I just wanna give you guys some facts and links to the information that I've accumulated over the interwebs about this new CGM, followed by my honest thoughts, suggestions, and questions for you guys, the users. So without further ado, let's talk about the facts in the prick. Now the Libre 3, it's the smallest, thinnest, wireless continuous glucose monitor ever approved. This is the actual size. What this is not a Libre 3, but it is in fact two pennies that I put together using some honey and then spray painted to look like a Libre 3. But it's impressive how small this thing really is. I'll be honest with you, if this thing was on my body, I'm pretty sure I would forget that it was on. And that essentially proves the branding of the Freestyle Libre system. Libre, which is the Latin or Spanish word for to be free. And I would feel like this thing on me all the time would feel like nothing on me all the time. I have used previous CGMs. Matter of fact, I have an Omnipod on right now. Two things, Omnipods are pumps, and so obviously they're gonna hold liquid and they're gonna have to be bigger. But this, compared to my Omnipod, is minute. It's small, it's nothing. I definitely am excited about how small this thing is. So the Libre 1 and 2 were roughly the size of two stacked quarters. The Libre 3, on the other hand, is about the size of two US stacked pennies, as I have previously stated. The amazing thing is that this is in fact a 70% size reduction. That's huge. Or small? I don't know. This is also environmentally sustainable, with about 41% less plastic and 43% less carton paper. Now, it has a one-piece applicator to reduce waste. That's cool. And there will be no projected price increase over the current Libre version. The Diatribe website, links below, shows that it is roughly $109 a month without insurance. And that's a good price. Anyone who has ever paid full price for a CGM knows $109, pretty good. Now the Libre 3 will indeed be a iCGM. What does that mean? Well, it will be able to be used in a closed-looped artificial pancreas system when partnered with a particular insulin pump. Now the website doesn't say which particular insulin pumps these will be, but details on these pumps will be released hopefully in the near future. However, the MedTech Drive website has mentioned possible integration with Tandem and Insulet devices, AKA the t-slim X2 and the Omnipod Horizon. Now this is a 14-day sensor with real-time smartphone capability, Bluetooth delivered glucose readings that are set to a 1 minute interval. The Libre 3 is getting its own mobile app, which will display real-time glucose levels, history and trends, and current information boasts a 60-minute warm-up period. That's right, just 60 minutes. Now, 60 minutes may not be a big deal to you if you're already using Libre 1 and 2, but if you're using Dexcom G6 like me and others, they have a 1 hour faster warm-up time. Dexcom is 2 hours, which is essentially 1 hour longer of not knowing what the heck is going on with your sugar, which is annoying. With the CE mark, it has been cleared to launch in Europe. In a few months, with pending FDA approvals, we should see it in the US. But according to clinicaltrials.gov, US trials were set to start back in July 2020 with no end date given. But with the current pandemic, who knows when they'll ever start and whether or not they'll ever get done. My hope is that it'll be soon. Once approved, this device will work for the pancreatically challenged ages 4 and up. Now time for honest thoughts, suggestions, and questions in the squeeze. Now, depending on who you ask, size may or may not be everything, but when we're talking CGMs, it is everything. If you're like me, you may have, at one time or 10 times, caught your CGM on something and half ripped it off of your arm or whatever body part you happen to be on, leaving a chunk of skin on the back of the adhesive and a lot of expletives coming out of your mouth. Maybe that's just me. Now, if this thing really is as small as they say it is, I would be elated to wear one. Or in the words of Flora, it would be
perfectly splendid.
Okay, a one-piece applicator. To be honest, I'm super curious as to how this might work. As y'all know, in a two-part CGM applicator insertion, the applicator normally houses a spring that releases a needle. Now, when the needle is inserted, it is withdrawn back into the applicator, leaving a tiny sensor wire under your skin. Which begs the question, if all of those moving parts and pieces are needed for the current versions of CGM insertion, how? Now, there's no projected price increase over the current, as I talked about earlier, but this is interesting because it adds an incentive for other manufacturers to keep their prices low in order to remain competitive. Now, this in turn passes the savings down to the consumer, and regardless of which system you use, we might see price decreases across the board. Fingers crossed. Now, for suggestions. Yes, I have a suggestion. Get the developers of the iOS and the Android apps to work on more devices. I hate, double hate.
Load entirely.
When things launch but don't work well with my phone, which is always a pretty new phone, I'm lucky to have that, but sometimes not lucky that it's the wrong one. You know what I'm saying. So what about you? Are you excited about the Libre 3? Or are you gonna wait for the G7? Do you have any suggestions for the manufacturer? I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments, or better yet, send me an email, or do both. Either way, it was good seeing you again. I'm Ben, I'm Type Me, and I'll see you next time.
Till then.